don't know a blaze across this. The girl named Prince Charmer. Straight, representing Canadian straight, suffering with MSR. Out.
Metro, 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 yabba.
You know it's about Shalanka. Represent for the Riffica.
Hello, my name is Latanya Style, aka Latitude.
You know it's Gabidan from Kingston, Jamaica.
This is Chucky Exclusive from the Exclusive Dancers.
Baby, it's me again, Craig Blackie from Blackie.
My name is Rapper Star from Drastic Star.
Alright, as you all know, this is Kempstar Dominant from Dominant TV.
I'm Kevin Campbell and I'm from the group Nala Skankers.
This here is the Fearless Family.
Yo, no, so me kill like you see me. I rest kill that. We have a kill like dance group with the J.A. You see me I say?
I'm chill overload, scandal.
Global Bop, the official number one 3-time international dancer for the year.
You don't know this is famous.
Alright. Hey, you're the world don't know how. Shelly, you really want to shelly. Energy.
Oh, I don't know energy.
It's all about the music, it's about the people, it's about everything in our culture.
It's all about vibe, attitude.
Alright, dancehall is a type of, it's our culture, you know what I'm saying? It's not really about dancing, it's about everything, the way you dress, the way you act, the slang, everything. That is dancehall, that is our thing.
Once anyone, any foreigners come out of that plane, whether you want to go Montego Bay, whether you want to come from Kingston, once you step out of that airport, you step in dance.
Dancehall is everything to us. It's a universal word for we as a peace. Dancehall is a thing like this when you're stressed out and down and you're thinking about a bag of things. You just come to boom, listen some music, some hardcore dancehall or some reggae and stay and that clear your mind from everything. Dancehall is a happy feeling, it's a happy moment.
Dancing in a hall. Okay, originally it's about a hall that you dance.
Dancehall is everybody that you see in a dancehall party. Dancehall is not about the dancers only. Dancehall is about the artists. Dancehall is about the selectors. Dancehall is about the lady that picks up the bottle or the gentleman that picks up the bottle. Dancehall is about the little kids who come and they beg your money. Dancehall is about the jerk chicken man. Dancehall is about the peanut man. Dancehall is about the soup man. Dancehall is about the camera man.
Dancehall was born from the ghetto.
Yeah, but can't tell the band.
You know what I'm saying? So people never couldn't really go uptown and express themselves really. So them just stay downtown and do them things. And what? It get big. Right now, dancehall take over.
The time when dancehall get big is when all the
one and only, see, Mr. Waki, Bogo, the greatest icon.
Because many people see back then dance, but never used to do it. Mostly like, people will go there more like a Michael Jackson, more like a Jesse, James Brown, I'm black and I'm brown. More like those people that we go do like their dance. But then, but now since Mr. Walker right, give us dance all moves, flowing through body,
body part differently where people never use the flow from that way, from that body part.
Dancer is a thing. If you not feel it, you can't do it. It have a flow. So when you do it, you feel me? It's like when you know white people over so a wave or a pop. It just a flow. Same so with dancer. When you do it, it have a flow. Cause if it not a flow, it not gonna look good.
Dancehall, man, a deadly dancehall. So dancehall is just a part of me. Yeah, part of every Jamaican. And I think it can be a part of everybody.
Love you, Dad! Not that bad, Rob.
Dancehall is life. Yeah. You have to love dancehall to do dance.
Dancehall is nothing without the ladies.
You can't tell a girl how to dance, right? You know?
All
right. If a girl want to dance, want to do man dance, was can. Too much booty is shaking. What for?
Well, honestly, you see, nothing is wrong with the booty shaking, man. But as we said, dancehall is a mixture of different cultures and so forth. And you know, as in, the girls are free to do what they want to do, and they can even do the male dances as well.
They can't stop them.
You don't know, at the end of the day, we just want to say, dance up on a wall. Out here, you understand? It wouldn't really matter when them want to shape the booty. Because we like the woman them shape the booty. You understand?
Yeah.
Dancehall is not all about whining and going and your head up and spin and all those things. Dancehall is it's a part of dancehall, but you have more to it. Okay? And the next thing, a male not supposed to do a girl step. That's killing me. That is killing me so much. A male supposed to do a male step. Leave the woman them thing alone. May I beg you the place? For the ladies called dancehall queen stuff. That is dancehall queen stuff. That is lady stuff.
For the queen.
For the man now, dancehall moves is for man. Women can do it, yes. sister of China Squad and the sister Madeleine back then. And you used to have the MOV with the 00B ladies. So I know the world is serious with ladies coming up with doing steps.
The dancing is so versatile. It's all about girls, it's all about guys being confident, being aggressive, being cool. It's a whole lot of things. You cannot explain it in one word.
I'm not really know how to explain that, but dancehall just come with me natural. I just get up every day and flow with it because it brings joy and fun to me.
We were born to dance. We were born to do this. This is our life. We grow into this.
The music itself, sitting around listening to a new beat that come out, give us a flavor, give us a feeling to express yourself. So really, is what we see in our surrounding inspires us to really create a move.
Some man there, I watch a next man lick up, he go beg it, so I don't know, beg no money, nothing for drink. You have your dirty money. When I roll out already, all you say.
The music gives me the energy, the vibe, and the ideas. The music dictates to me, so it allows me to be creative and express myself.
The song said, Gaza man crazy. How would it go if I would?
Gaza man crazy. No.
Alright, Roadrunner. No, Roadrunner is a cartoon, right? And it go beep beep.
Beep beep.
Yeah. It said Roadrunner. You pretend like you're running, right? Your heart is not
Well, we get inspiration from everything. If you see a man on a bike, you just say right now, new dance. Bike back. Yeah. See a man on a bike, he just says alright, bike back. Or you see somebody on a piano, and you say right now, piano. You see somebody a sweep, so you say sweep.
You might just be walking down the street and you might see a little boy or a little girl or even a mad person doing something, and something comes to your head automatically, and out of that comes a dance move. Even just being around, being in a kitchen cooking, something can come to you.
Go say the word, new dance will occur. Let you rave a thing near to that bird. Try not to say to them when you see them a swagger and a swerve. You are the nerve, I go matter, and we not deserve.
Just wanting to be different and more creative than as a dance
move. It's like every month, it's like that thing about something new. So it's like every season we come out with something new. You understand? 15 years ago, and it's like every turn, be a new dance. So it's like none of my dancing never scared yet. Remember, I come up with Shell, Chuck, and the Herb. One dance, oh God, man. Look at 90s rock, creep with the cold food. You understand? Pressure them. Yeah, fix it up. Then you go dancing, man. And I remember this. Never stop still. Oh.
We have created a new dance move every day as quick as possible as they can, because it keeps the culture going. We know with a new dance move, you have to get old and stale and you never have nothing new for you.
Never anyone try and create a dance move. No, it won't work. When you try too much, it won't work. Dance move come to you naturally. Okay? You can't go in a studio and create a dance move and then you come into us and say this is a dance move. No.
So you find that when dancers create dance moves, it's only last 2 weeks or 1 week or 2 months the most. Bogle taught me that when you create a dance move, it should last at least 6 months or up to a year. Willy Bunks lasted 5 years.
A dance, a real dancehall move created on the street. If you really look, you have a lot of legendary dancehall dancers here. Talking about Mr. Boko, I'm talking about Mr. Janai, I'm talking about Blase Blase, and I'm talking about MOB, for instance, because they are a legend of dancehall. Long time. You know, but he's not an IMOB again, he's a original team. You understand?
From me, I look a youth, I grew up. I always see Bogle up on the TV and dance and Ding Dong, Sadiki, all of the man them a dance. I mean, say, you know, I want to be a dancer one day. I'm go up on the big screen, them two, and go up on TV. I mean, say, I'm going to try our fights. So I left from country and come to Kingston.
You see, as a world dance and a vocal dance that. So from them time then you're inspired a vocal. So comes me, I get love it. Love dance and plus love feel dance.
Shelly Belly, Vogel, Lanai. From me I go school is a dream. When we watch my TV and Shelly Belly my dance. So one day more I come.
My inspiration, I don't know, Bogle, color, Sadiq, the dancehall fraternity of the first beginning.
I don't know, you know, one big part of the dancehall, you know, you see, if you have the push. Makes sense. You have to get the cranny.
The cranny.
That thing, that big butt thing, green butt thing.
We roll up, sir.
And you roll up in white paper.
Puffy?
Yeah. You see me? It's a big part of life. Nah, dancer.
Very hard. Very, very, very hard. Because really, the pay, the money for being a dancer in Jamaica, not cut it. Because you don't get paid for God dance. You don't get paid for some video. You don't get paid for nothing if you just shoot them. You have to just run, we'll run going on them. So if you say the power, you don't hope for them hot videos. I know none of them get paid. We just do it because we love it.
These people out here not really support, they don't like dancehall that much. Like how people in the Europeans and Swedish take dancehall more serious than us.
There are people in Jamaica that don't know what is dancehall, and dancehall is for Jamaica.
In Jamaica itself, as much as dancehall is the culture, the bigger it's them try to fight it, but we keep it alive. You get what I say?
We have to do it for us. You understand? Because the highest society in Jamaica
don't respect and believe in dancehall. They don't believe in dancehall because they said that, oh, dancehall is the street and yes, too much ghetto people.
But they have to know this.
And I'm going to tell someone this now. Every garrison in Jamaica, every bad area in Jamaica, dancehall is the one that keeps the peace between two bad communities. Okay?
That's
and it's a real thing. Because you can have war there, man. For instance, me and Sri Lanka are firing guns at each other. You understand? And then the music just gets us together. The survive out here, they don't know. As a mechanic said, they don't know.
They don't
what
know
what we feel inside. You understand? As a
they
dancer
don't know what
in Jamaica. Serious. As a dancer in Jamaica, I met up from my friend. Well, me in the street from about call it 10 years. You understand? So long, and I still don't get that big break that I need. So that will show you, and I create a lot of dance moves that I can think of.
Party, we dance all night, but sometimes we have to pay to go into the party,
and we have to pay, we have to buy our own liquor at this party. So that is how we face in Jamaica. Many people don't know, and we have to meet seven days a week, do dance all moves out there for people. Dance. No people don't know how we feel in the street dancing as a dancer, sweating. Sometimes you people have a dollar in your pocket.
We take dancehall as our living, our lifestyle, right? As our 9-to-5, right? So we don't just take it as just dancing because we want to dance. We take it up as a job, as a career.
To do our hair, get our nails done, wear a nice outfit. It's a cost and we don't really get it back by going out, so it's a real investment and it's really hard.
We try to look good, but deep down inside, you don't know what's popping. You have to come and ask. We will tell you what.
Yeah, it's all to be a dancer.
In order to be a dancer in Jamaica, you have to first be a
established in the streets.
You have to just stay in the right hands of the people, because you see, if you just coming out the street and it's a dance every night, that don't make no sense. You have to have a team. We respect you and love you and the people, and we gravitate to that.
It's not really easy. I don't know, nothing in life is really easy. You have to reach out and get.
How are you think, you know? How are you work, you know? How are you can do, you know? So if you say dancing and dancing, you want dancing, you know? Just take it serious from your heart.
There are a lot of talented dancers up there, isn't it? So for getting out your talent plus your education.
For the average youth, it is difficult because the average youth is just a dancer. You know, and we dance because we love it. We dance because we hear music. We dance because Jamaica is a society that dance. So because we have not been educated about the business of dancehall, then sometimes it becomes difficult to make a career out of it, and because it's not formalized and people not really institutionalize it, then it's kind of difficult to become a professional dancer. You have to seriously decide to educate yourself.
Give it to her one time. Jump. I'm gonna make a full turn. I'm gonna move from to her right leg. I'm gonna give it to her two times. I'm gonna use the knee now and couple her leg. One, two.
Your mother, girl.
Send me a man.
We don't, some of the dancers don't market themselves, right? And some, not everybody, but some will teach and some will cannot teach, because it's not every dancer can be a teacher, right? Dancing is different than teaching, because you have to name the basic of the steps and count and everything.
To be a dancer anywhere. I think dancers don't get as much respect as probably artists or doctors or lawyers. You know, it's a career that most people take as it's a thing that most people take as a hobby or extracurricular activity versus a career or something that you can be progressive in. So it's difficult anywhere, but in Jamaica it's particularly difficult. European dancehall scene is oh lord, that question.
Okay, from my point of view about the European dancer, yeah, you have some of them who come to Jamaica to know about the true Jamaican and the dancehall move. You have some of them who watch the YouTube to see the dancehall move. That some of them even attend the classes them in the European part to catch the dancer.
Yeah, I've really seen a lot of European dancers, and I think, yeah, they're coming on very well. Doing dancehall, it's a wow for me. And some of them really like them, feel the passion that we Jamaicans have for dancehall. It's like them sharing the same passion as us.
respect them because I do push dancer to your max.
Yeah.
They might help uplift dancer, help the culture.
I just love when the people support our culture because it's a very good look for us. So people can see that what we're doing is not just for fun, it's for professional dance world.
Yeah, it's okay. They dance, they kind of adopt like the Jamaican dance.
All them do them thing because them catch a thing them fast.
Well, I have it. Well, like some of the man they were born Jamaican. I mean myself, you have it harder than me. Not as much as what I've seen the Japanese, cause it's like right now anywhere in Jamaica you can see a lot of Japanese. Them are taking the dancehall thing to another level. Them love it.
Full up in ya.
Full up Jamaica. Man, I tell you like.
I'll sound them up.
Did me? I'll sound them up.
I'll sound them up in Jamaica.
I select sound of a dance.
Can't tell them cinema. Can't tell them cinema. I'm black.
Them love the dancehall.
I spread all over Japan, all over the world. Jamaica dancer, now the dead, forever. A Tottenham squad, get on the dance with full flags. You ready?
Japan now, them people they learn quick. At the first place we go to teach dance, they show it's not a dance like that, they teach dance. You understand? But Japan telling the truth and the youth and sugar cane, and him say, Shelly Belly, you can do it, but we learn that stuff. I'm sorry, right there, just easy, come alive, on to it.
In our heart, love the effect, all Japanese.
Yeah, listen. Me no bad, no sense. Me no chicken, chicken get tan.
Come
send down, go send down me.
I'm sick.
That's a good thing for us Jamaicans. You know that the world we have put out all of these years, it's reaching places, it's reaching somewhere. It has reached people all over the world, all walks of life. You see me?
Well, they're European dancers that I really rate and have a whole lot of respect for because they try and study dancehall culture and they help it impart the knowledge from the rest of the world, you know, because a number of things that other places in Europe and in Asia know about dancehall is because of European dancers, because they've been at the international scene more than us.
You have some of the
Yes, doing dancehall and really love dancehall.
But who will really want to know about your culture and, you know, dig deep and find out what it is to know dancehall on a whole?
People don't want to learn from Jamaicans because I'm here in Europe right now, and I noticed that a lot of the teachers, the thousands of dancehall teachers, hardly participate in a workshop when someone actually buys a ticket for a Jamaican to come here and share. And you know, I just feel like it's a little bit disrespectful. I don't know what the situation is. They think they know it all, but I think you never stop learning. Life is about always learning. And if you're earning from something, you should at least support.
Even though I'm a dancer, even though we create so much step, we Jamaicans still learning. So why some of you guys in Europe feel like you learn a lot and you know a lot? No. Because we still learning and you guys don't start to learn it. Believe me when I say that.
The dancehall scene in Europe is very complicated. It's very competitive. It's very mixed up. And the reason I say that is I've been practicing dancehall for over 15 years. I grew up in dancehall, and all those 15 years, dancehall was just fun. Dancehall was just about being you, expressing yourself, going to parties, just living life and being happy.
One advice I have to give to all foreigners who's doing dancehall: don't play with it, don't mess it up, because it's not what you guys think.
Listen to the important point. I have a problem with European dancers who, male dancers who do one job, male dancers who do patch, male dancers who split, male dancers who dance to female songs.
Dancehall is about knowing your culture. So for me, I believe European dancers, some can dance, but some misinterpret the culture of dancehall.
Now, dancehall has rules, and if you cannot respect the rules, get them out. Do not dance, leave dancehall alone.
Now I'm going to tell them this now. Lyrics is not something to dance on, because you can't do dancehall dancing and dancing to lyrics, because if you cut the dance move short,
okay? So for instance, somebody wanna see a gangster shirt, gangster search. You go like bam, and then you move to a next one. It only look good when you're doing it with a team or a crew. But you alone dancing it, fuck, you look like a crap. You're doing a different step, okay? The battles that you guys doing, crap it. It's not a battle, okay? Because you can't battle and dance so. Y'all know what we want, no. That is not a battle. And then you're gonna do it with a girl and a boy. A girl can battle a boy, yes.
Yeah, we got two.
But come on now, man. The song is
anyway.
The way how you guys battle, it's not no. We don't look at, we don't consider that as a dancehall battle. Because dancehall battle is dancehall battle is vicious. You don't know about the battles out of it. You just get the street part that we do freely. Battle part is different. You understand? It's serious when I say that. We make the move too well. Way for the street. I shouldn't say this to you, but it's true. And the way to kill people when it comes on to battle.
Yeah.
No, not literally kill them. No, not kill people.
Not literally kill.
Like shoot them with my style. Big bad, wicked and wild. You see? Spiritually.
I think a lot of the European dancers are trying to control, they're trying to own something that is not theirs. And I say that proudly, that Jamaica is the originator of dancehall. No argument, no in at that.
The dancehall move, not ragga jam move. I hear I said dancehall move. That is Jamaican hardcore dancehall move that the street do in Jamaica.
Ragga jam, everybody knows where ragga jam comes from. That is dancehall.
A lot of European dancers send me some video, okay, I create a dance move, but that is not dancehall.
No European dancer can create dance move. None.
So sorry, I'm telling you the truth.
No, listen to me. That is European move. Dancer move is Jamaican move. Don't get it wrong, I love you people, but don't get it messed up. If you create a move from Europe, that is European move. This way we create all the rhythmical, spiritual, and a lot of dance, that is dancer move. You understand? So people, don't think you can create dancer move. No, that's European move.
I cannot certify it as a dancer move. No Jamaican dancer can certify it as a dancer move. You have to come to Jamaica. You have to go into the streets. It's a process. You have to go to the street, you have to go to the selector, the people. Once it, well, let me tell you how you know your dance move is a hit. Not if dancers are doing your dance move, but if everybody in general is doing your dance move. If you go to Jamaica and you see everybody in Jamaica doing your move, that is a dancehall move. If it's only dancers doing your dancehall move, it is not a dancehall. It is just a step. And that is the difference.
European dancers are creating steps, but they're not really not necessarily dancehall steps. You can't call it a dancehall step. Dancehall step has to be created by a Jamaican in the Jamaican space, because the dance is about what happens in the Jamaican inner city space. Hey.
We need to have more, I don't even want to use the word unity because that's so cliche and so used and abused. So I just think we just need a little more respect, a little more understanding, a little more appreciation, and then dancehall would be how it was before, where there's no competition, confusion, or any mix-up, as in what is real dancehall. There shouldn't even be an argument in that.
So, my people in Europe, I want you to know, no disrespect, you know we love you because you make me and we make you, you understand? Spiritually. So we want you to know that. We want you to just invest the move to your best ability and make me feel proud of you in Jamaica. Respect, not love, spiritual. Critical. Mention.
Bullshit! No dancer should register any dance move because Bogle taught me that everybody should dance and dance is for everybody. If I register my move, why would I scare a dancer in Slovakia or Australia to do my move? Do my move.
Alright. When you say copyright dancehall steps, it's like for me, you can't copyright, it don't make sense copyright a step. Your one step. It means that, okay, you don't want nobody else to do your step. And I mean, copying a dancehall step, just one step, not going to give you as a dancer much recognition.
See, the step can be modified 100 years. So it's a difficult to just copyright one step.
If you have a copyright, a dancer step, it's like you have a copyright, you have to say, you have a 500 man who wave up in a couple of days and
then 100 dancers are come forward. I said, but I'm me first do the dance move then. You know what I mean? And I'm me first use my waist that way, then I'm me first use my foot that way. So.
No, that not going to work. You can register a sequence of move like a choreography.
Choreography or a routine come out of your creative genius based on how you use the steps to create that routine. So that can be copywritten. Actual dancer step, nothing.
And I do not agree with dancers copyrighting dance moves because dancing is not a free for all, it's for everybody. It's not about just making money, it's about the spirit, it's about the love.
Registering something doesn't mean someone has to pay for it. Mark you, a music, a song, a producer registers, copyrights his song, and we all play it every day in our radio. We're not paying for it by playing it. So if people use our steps, if we register it, it's not about paying for it.
To tell you the truth about copyright, it makes sense. Because guess what now? You can earn from it. And it tell the world, say, it's yours. Because enough people are thief dance and they don't stand up to them. You understand?
Dancers should license their steps so nobody can take it from them. So the world knows that that step is their own.
I believe dancers are supposed to copyright them, not them dance move, yes. Because the reason why I'm saying this, there's a lot, and a lot of European dancers doing this. A lot of our steps and twist and turn it and call it a different step. Okay? Listen, you disrespect us when you do that. When you see a step and you turn it and it looks exactly the same, like a same step like one of us did, you disrespect us.
okay? Because you call it a different name. So, as I'm saying, dancers should copyright their dancing. And when I say this, I don't want you guys to get this wrong. Every European can go respect. You don't have no problem with it.
Globally dance all go a set elite team. Take it to them. How tell them say a dance and represent straight? How tell them say elite team? Riffical squad. And the whole world a dance to a thing, so you don't know elite, take it to them. Flurb it, action. How tell them say KO, dance like fatal. Gringo. How tell them say African pride the next big thing, I go shot them in a. We a shoot.
That is a good idea. Because, as we say, for boss of Jamaica, for them, for people from Europe, watch you move them on YouTube, take us set them and I teach it. And now give us the credit. No, we still the author. I dance.
You understand? But they see we dancing and create our dancing, but put it up on the YouTube and try to make meals and only for money for our dance move. And we know a lot. You understand? We know a lot. That is why we respect the people who come to Jamaica and see how we survive out here and they work with us to make we get this green break to show our true dancehall in Jamaica.
And everybody's there. can do easy, scan do up. And you know say we do all Japan, cause we don't care. Team, love you, babies. Let me take around all my ladies. Big up! I'm gonna say big up to all of France, the world of Paris. You see? Because we're gonna see them soon. Big up to all of Europe people. We love